Hi guys, today we are going to talk about blue prism, global timeout, and weight stage. As you can see the diagram, how the weight stage is configured. See the wait for time. You have the check-in field. If time exists, then it will go to timeout. Then after the reached timeout, it will go to system exception. So this is the flow. You can see here in flowchart. Wait. Timeout, a field, if timeout exists, then it will go to the system exception. See, the wait stage is configured below. See, the wait stage, the element in action, wait stage. You can see element parameters, the condition, the wait stage is configured with condition sec exist, the flag it will check into equal flag with comparison mode, and the value will be true. So this is the configuration done in wait stage. Can you see here the wait stage has configured with timeout global timeout. It means in initialize page you have small, large or medium kind of global timeout or delay, you mentioned that. So based on the configuration it will taken here global timeout. Now you can see the data item. This is the question. The data item global timeout L, that is, it is a number data item configured to 60. The number data item global timeout is configured to 60. Maybe you can take it as 60 seconds or milliseconds. So when the process is running, this flow process is running, the wait stage will. So now you can guess how the this is the process. The process is global timeout with 60 seconds. You go filled with check exist and wait and timeout. So now you can analyze how it will work. The first option is wait for 60 seconds before looking for the time element. Wait for 60 seconds before looking for the time element. So, if the element found, okay, element found, the code will drop into click in field navigate stage. Field navigate stage. If the element is not found, if the element is not found, a system exception will be thrown. This is the first option. When you see the second option, start looking for the time element immediately. If the element is found, the code will wait. The code will wait for 60 seconds before dropping into click field navigation stage. If the element is not found, if element is not found after 60 seconds, then system exception will throw. This is the second option. Can you see the third option? Option C. Start looking for the time element immediately. So whenever the element is found, so check exist, checking whenever the element is found. If time element, it means start looking for the time element immediately whenever element found. See, if the element is found, the code will, if element found, then the code will run, code will immediately drop into the click in field navigation stage. If the element is not found after 60 seconds, a system exception will be thrown. This is the four options. See, option C. That is exactly correct. So now see what, whenever the timeout happens, it will go to the exception stage. If not timeout happens, so you are making a check exist. The check exist will check the time element is there or not. If the time element is there, then immediately drop into the click in field. If not, then it will wait for the 60 seconds. See, after 60 seconds as well, it will not found the element, then the system exception will be thrown. This is the flow for the process. Thanks guys, thanks for watching this. Then we can see more about our next videos.